Dr. Hajiyev, thank you very much for joining us. This is the second Caspian Corridor Conference. What has changed in the region since you held the first one 2 years ago?
No, this is the second Caspian Corridor region. I have the conference, and I have to say that it's going very successfully. And we had one last year, and I would say in terms of topics covered last year, in terms of the businesses which we managed to bring in framework of this conference to the region, I have to say that it's we had a very good year just in between. And the deals which had been signed during the first Caspian Corridor Conference has been fulfilled so far. I want just to remember the deals which we signed, not we are the customers and the participants of the conference. It's an offtake agreement between BP and Methanol, Azmeka Methanol, Azerbaijan Methanol Company. And now I can say that they have successfully done this project, and they are about just to export their products abroad together with, of course, together with BP. And so, as you see, it's pretty in our face that it's not a conference in sake of the conference. So it brings value for businesses between the UK and Azerbaijan, and I would say that not only between the UK and Azerbaijan, but the UK and the rest of the world and the Caspian region, Caspian Corridor countries, which are, you know, that there is five of them. And during this particular conference this year, today, we are going to witness the signing of the deal and contract between two companies, but in this case, it's not a company, but two counterparts. It's a government of Kazakhstan and UK-based and publicly listed company. It's a compact GTL gas to liquid. For me, it's a great deal. It's a great opportunity that we're just about to witness it. The signing. It's converting gas to liquid. And, Kazakhstan is going to provide associated gas, which they are burning out. And the UK is going to bring new technology, converting gas to liquid to oil products, which is great from a business standpoint, which is great from a conference standpoint. And now it's not only Azerbaijan is involved, it's we got regional countries to be involved in our conference and in the business which we are facilitating to bring up.
How important is it for companies within the region to have access via a conference like this to the capital markets, as opposed to finding investment from local partners or from governments in other regions?
From a capital market standpoint, I think there is wages to go, and there is huge opportunities, and I'm very grateful to London Stock Exchange. I think this conference laid an opportunity, first of all, for cooperation between stock exchange on the UK one side, London, the London Stock Exchange, and stock exchange of Caspian region countries. And of course, this opportunity for companies just go public on one side to access capital market, to establish themselves and to do their homework, just to bring them themselves up to date, up to market. I hope and I'm sure that next year maybe, so we can witness something new in this regard. I hope that we'll have a company just going public on the London Stock Exchange from the region.
This morning on the panel discussion, you talked about geopolitics on the one hand and geoeconomics, and what may make sense from an economic point of view, and what may be possible from a political point of view in terms of the whole region. Could you expand a little bit more on those comments and, you know, how you see things are heading from a strategic perspective?
From strategic perspective, all these countries, not all of them, of course, at least four of them, excluding Iran, we used to be in one country. We used to live in one country, Soviet Union. Since that, more than 20 years, we are independent. Of course, every and each country has its own interests from macroeconomic standpoint, geoeconomic standpoint, but they have a lot in common, and they have problems which are to be solved in the future. I strongly believe that such kind of conferences like we have every year here, conferences can facilitate the relationships and maybe not solve the problem. It's up to politics, it's up to leadership of countries. Caspian corridor, let's say, countries. But at the same time, we can bring people together, we can bring governments together if you want, and we can, what we are doing, we can influence somehow from economic standpoint, from business standpoint, decision-making process.
What are the opportunities for banks such as yours within the region to develop their business internationally, whether it's through provision of new types of service or just generally developing the banking as hub of the region?
Actually, in this regard, we are doing our best when it comes to IBA, let's say, where every year we do something new. We're trying to bring expertise from Western countries, from Western world, and from Middle East, if you want. Just recently, last year, we dedicated our part of our activity to bringing Islamic banking to the Azerbaijan, particularly, and I would say not to my mind actually. It's something new. It's a new opportunity, not only for Azerbaijan but for other countries as well. Now we are trying to expand this such kind of new products, not only within Azerbaijan but to the region outside of Azerbaijan. How successful will be, so we'll see.